I'm a pit bull, and I approve this message.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Conversations with a Pitbull Live. I would be Foster Quarter.
And I'm the amazing bearded man. Thank you. Thank you.
And that would be Chris rocking the board behind us, yep. The man of the hour keeping us on the air. Hey, it is Friday, February somebody. Third or fourth?
February.
March.
Damn.
April.
Really?
See, I just got up.
Like brothers, man. They always try to extend Black History Month like the whole year. It's like July. Like.
Right. Well, I was trying to keep my DMV payment from being due.
Oh, like, yeah. You seen them red notices?
That fine, man. They said, you know, if you don't pay this thing by the 6th, we will not only come get your driver's license, but, you know, we might take anything you own. So, hey. Here we go. Hey, today, right away, because I know she's got limited time because she's a woman of, airplanes and bus terminals and train stations and conventions and autographs and stuff. We got Deidre from Pinups for Pitbulls.
All right.
Yeah, so she's supposed to be hollering at us. Wait a minute. Is she on the phone or is she Skyping? She got to probably be on the phone because she's probably in some train station, airport, hangar, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. What is that? Is that Deidre?
You must be talking about me.
Hey, baby. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. Oh, man. I didn't know. I thought you were Skyping because I would have had some pictures and stuff of you.
Oh, it's all good.
Yeah, man. I thought you was going to be on the Skype. Where you at?
I am in Asheville right now, actually, at our home base, at our store. We are leaving in a few days for Baltimore and then Philly, and then we're on the road for like 2.5 weeks. So it's.
Oh, okay. You guys driving?
Yeah, we're driving. We're taking the pups.
Oh, okay. So you take like a van, or you got to a road bus?
No, I wish. Right now we're operating out of a little SUV.
Oh, okay. We got the SUV rolling down the highway. Oh,
exactly.
Like Dolomite, you know, I don't know if you ever heard of Dolomite, but, you know.
I've heard of Dolomite.
Okay, I managed him for like 20 years, you know.
That's awesome.
And he used to say to me when he said, you know, when you're standing in the grocery store, you know, and that bill comes to $125. That lady behind the stand is not going to ask you, sir, how did you make this money?
You know? That's so awesome.
Yeah, you know, so when you guys show up at whatever, you know, event that you're going to be at with the calendars and the love and the education and stuff that you're spreading, now, you know, nobody's going to say, how did you guys get here, you know?
That is true.
Yeah, they just be happy you're there.
Yeah, we're happy to be there.
Yeah, say hello to Danny. He's up in the house today.
Hey, hi, Deidre,
Danny.
How are you doing?
Great, how are you? How's married life?
That's great. You know, we just moved into a new house and stuff, so me and Foster spent some time building a dog kennel and getting the dogs adjusted to being over there. I had to take over ownership of my father's dogs. He passed away, so I had to take over control of these dogs, and they're getting adjusted. They're having a good time, so you know, it's a learning process. I've been in an apartment my whole life, so you know, having your own place and managing, you know, like pets.
Having to fix the things that break.
Yeah, you know, that, but also just managing dogs, you know, that aren't like, you know, just inside dogs, you know what I mean? It's like I have a brand newfound, rekindled respect for people that are doing dog training or running these rescues that are handling like 20, 30 dogs at a time.
That.
I'm like, man, dude, I'm getting the workout just cleaning up after these guys. They seem to get it.
So that cage is hanging?
Oh, yeah, they're good.
That kennel? Oh, yeah. You got to see, we built this kennel, Deidre. It's the ticket. So tell me, though, we got a new calendar, huh?
We're actually shooting it in a week and a half. That's why we're going to Philly.
Is that right?
2016 calendar, yep.
Oh, that's great, because I saw something in the news about, what was it, the New York Times or something? Or New York Post?
Huh? Yeah, the New York Post.
Yeah,
I said on the 2015 calendar. Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah, I was like, hey.
10 pictures.
Well, you know, you got to make sure that, you know, you got to come here because I don't think we got a chance to pump the 25th. I'm choking on my Pitbull energy drink here. I don't think we got a chance to pump the 2015 calendar.
Yeah, we still have some, so we can pump it right now.
Yeah, absolutely. All you guys, if you know, you still got, what, 8 months left in this year or something like that? So it's a lot of year left, you know? So
April is really hot, too, right now.
Yeah. So so we got up on the screen, you know, Deidre's page, and that's the calendar with the little dog in the Navy suit?
No.
Sailor suit.
Navy suit.
Huh?
Are you thinking of our new T-shirt?
Oh, that's the T-shirt.
Design on it.
Oh yeah, with the dog with the
sailor cap on.
Right.
Yeah, we just made that's our new design. One of our pinups designed that for us of a sailor pup, so that we had like a traditional tattoo style.
Yeah.
Oh. We love it.
Oh yeah, that's cool. Well, you know, I'm an ex-sailor, you know, Navy guy myself, so.
How did you guys choose the models for this year's calendar, did you?
For 2015?
The new one that you guys are about to go shoot.
So we do a model call on our website every year, and we open it up to people around the world, and the only stipulation is whoever gets chosen has to get there themselves with their dog. So we have gotten girls from as far as Canada so far who have been selected. But we do a pretty extensive application on our website and have people upload pictures of their dogs and let us know what kind of advocacy work they do or what they're interested in doing and if they've ever volunteered with us, things like that. But we're really trying to build an army across the globe, so the girls who end up in the calendar we count on to be, you know, our representative in whatever region that they're in.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of the main ways that we pick them. And then beauty and brains help.
Mm-hmm.
In addition to having a pretty awesome dog, which is pretty easy.
Yeah, being able to walk and chew gum helps a lot, man.
It does.
So for people...
Being able to speak you know, about the dogs and speak well about them and not be hostile always helps as well.
So for people that aren't familiar with the... You know, with your calendar or calendars in general, you know, in this world, like what would you say really distinguishes your guys' calendar from... perhaps some other calendars, or why should people even be interested in what you guys are doing?
So what we do is the calendar itself helps to fund our ability to go around the country and educate people about dogs and laws affecting them. So really it's one of our main fundraisers. So purchasing our calendar helps people to support our mission to educate people about pit bull type dogs and really all dogs. And in addition to that, our calendar I think is separate just because it's not just pretty girls and, you know, in a calendar or just great dogs, but it's a combination of both. And these are people who are out there speaking on behalf of your dog and my dog every day who believe in the cause and believe in the mission. So it's definitely something a little extra than just, you know, another pretty girl.
Right. How do you come up with those designs, you know, the caption for each girl and stuff? Is that a pretty extensive process?
That's probably one of the easier parts, just because we have a really great creative team. The photographer, Celeste Giuliano, and her husband, David Seidman, do the photography and layout for us. And we conceptualize it together, and then they storyboard it. And we're on set with them making the shot happen. And things that we have to think about are, you know, how is this going to translate to somebody who doesn't know what we're doing or know what we're going after. So even if something seems cute at first to them, they might not realize that it might have a negative effect on the dogs if we shoot it a certain way. Mm-hmm. So we need to think about things like that as well. For instance, we're talking about using a motorcycle this year in our 2016 calendar, but if the girl has a dog on a leash and she's sitting on a motorcycle, you know, that would look really weird to somebody who's a dog advocate, even though it might look cool to somebody who just likes cool pictures.
Right.
So, you know, if you're riding along with your dog on a motorcycle,
that's a problem.
You, it would be really bizarre.
But yeah.
That's things that they don't, you know, that aren't on their mind because they're not thinking of it from an advocacy standpoint. So
right.
We team up to make sure that what we're framing in that picture really reads well to the general public.
Right.
And we want it to be happy, and we want people to see that these are just dogs and they're individuals and that they're having a good time too, you know.
Yeah. All right. So you're going to be in Philadelphia for the shoot, or you're going for the convention?
We're going to Baltimore first for a tattoo convention, and that's next weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And from Baltimore, we're driving on to Philadelphia to do the shoot. It takes us about 8 days to shoot the whole calendar, and then a few months for them to get the pictures finished and to start the layout process.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a pretty involved, long process, but it is pretty much the bread and butter for Pinups for Pitbulls to be able to do what we do. Without it, we don't really have grant funding because people don't understand our name and don't really understand the education side of missions as much as if you have, you know, a dog that you show metrics on, how that dog resulted or spay and neuter.
Hey, Deidre?
Yeah.
Hold on a second. I got Paula here on the Skype. I need to say hello to her because she's sitting there like I don't see her. Hello, dear.
Hi, Paula.
Hi.
Hey, how are you today? You gonna tell?
Good, you?
Good. So, hey, we got Deidre on the phone here. We're talking to her. The do you have dogs today?
Of course I have dogs.
Oh, well, that's a wonderful thing because I was wondering, you know, I think on Tuesday I cut you and your dogs off or something. Is that somebody, Christian? No. I cut you and your dogs off a little early there, you know? So maybe, Danny, just maybe I'm the cause of some dog that got put to sleep. Hey, is that me?
No, that's definitely not you.
Oh, okay. I was wondering. I was like,
no, man. I was just showing off some of these pictures from some of their previous calendars, and you get to see how wonderfully done this their product is. I mean, it's just very well conceived, and the dogs and the girls, and just the photography is awesome. So, you know, when you guys buy a calendar, you're not just getting something that's going to put in your drawer. This is something that you'd be happy to have on your wall somewhere, or an excellent gift, I think.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, because you should. No, that ain't me. Now that I look at the close-up, that wasn't me. That was
My last year's one, the one that she gave was, you know, she autographed it and everything.
Is that right?
It
yeah, was, that was cool. Is Deidre back?
I'm here.
Hey.
Hi.
Okay, we're doing our technology thing here, you know.
Yeah, no worries.
So you after the photo shoot, you say hello to Paula.
Hi, Paula.
Hi. Glad you could make it today.
Thank you for having me. I'm so excited to be here.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, Paula didn't want you on the show. You know that, right?
I know. She was like, please say no.
I know. I was and she called me. She was like, damn, you in this calendar. And I was like, well, wait, but they're naked. Paula was like,
you know us, naked with dogs.
That's right. And Paula was like, this is the dog show. And I was like, yeah, but they're naked. You know? so no, but truly, you know, it was very nice of her to run you down because I guess I had mentioned it somewhere, and, you know, that's the wonderful thing about her and Cheryl. They actually listen to what I say and pay attention. You know, if I could just get my real wife to do that, God, I'd be happening, man. You know, it's like, and I'm going to rub it in her face, though. There are two women that really listen to me, you know. So you going to a convention after the photo shoot?
Before the photo shoot. Uh-huh.
And what
is it? 3-day convention in Baltimore.
What is it again?
It's called the Baltimore Tattoo and Arts Convention. We do it every year in Baltimore, Maryland.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and it's actually one of the really cool things about us doing all these tattoo conventions over the last few years is other groups are starting to figure out that it is a very positive experience, especially if you're doing education or rescue.
Yeah.
So we started to see a lot of rescues showing up to all these different conventions that we've been a part of for all these years. So it's nice to see
other people
kind of taking up that opportunity and, you know, watching and seeing that it is definitely worthwhile.
Exactly, because it's not your basic dog crowd.
Exactly, and they're all really dog people, which is great.
Yeah, it's cool to see that kind of synergy. Sometimes you find it in interesting places like that, like the tattoo people and stuff like that. But, you know, I mean, especially with these dogs, like the pit bulls and stuff, you know, there's a lot of times you find a lot of similarities with their owners. They're certain types of cats, you know. I'm not saying that they're all, like, tattooed, like, whatever.
No,
people who
understand being discriminated.
Yeah, you know, people that have they have a better understanding of that and what it feels like, and also, you know, people that don't mind somebody pulling them down the street too. They like that.
When your dog shouldn't be pulling you down the street, actually.
Right.
You know. Hey, man, I spoke to Fred the other day.
How is he?
He's good.
I haven't spoken to him enough lately.
I know, man. He's good. You know, he's like smelling the roses of life right now, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's getting his parents are, you know, about to move in next door and everything, but he's really, really good. And, you know, so everybody, we're talking about Fred Cray, the number one, you know.
Number one attorney to the dogs.
That's right. You know, he is the man in Florida and wherever you may be and you need some advice. If it's a pit bull thing, you know, Fred Cray is the only person to call, you know. So you're going to be on the road for how many weeks?
It's a little under 3 weeks.
Oh, that's hard. So you take your dogs with you?
Yeah, we're taking them with us. We get Airbnb house rentals whenever we take them with us so that they can feel comfortable and we can be comfortable with them. And
yeah.
When you guys going to drop the 2016 calendar, like later on, like towards the end of the year, like in winter sometime?
Yeah, probably in September.
Uh-huh.
And we'll be pre-ordering it before that, but probably September. Oh, and there's a dog walking into the store right now. hi, how are you? Hi, guys. Oh, my goodness. Hi.
Yeah.
You really cute dogs walking in. Real quick, also, December 11th and 12th, I'm going to be in L.A. I'll probably be there before that, but I'll be in L.A. for the Pets Winter Wonderland Pet Expo. Maybe we can coordinate something.
Oh, absolutely.
You got the cord.
Absolutely. Yeah, we have to coordinate. You know, you definitely come by here, you know. I think, like, last year, you know, lazy old Paula, you know, she took the end of the year off, you know. As much as I wanted to work, you know, she said.
All on her,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, she said we were shutting down for the year, so we didn't do much of anything in December, I think. But, yeah, for sure, since you're coming in, we'll definitely be working right up until Christmas, you know. So, hey. So now Paula told me that you had to go, you know, if that's...
Yes, I do have to run and make a quick appointment. Do you mind if I just take a picture of your dogs? Hold on 1 second.
All right. And then...
I'll go some puppies real quick. Hi, you're so cute.
Yeah. and we have Regina with us today. How are you, dear?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Good. So you in Virginia still, or are you on the road?
No, I'm in Virginia.
You're in Virginia? All right, cool. So we're going to do some dogs, I guess, as soon as Deidre comes back.
Foster, thank you for having me, Danny. Thank you, Paula.
Hey, tell them where they can go. I mean, we've been putting the T-shirt up on the screen, but just tell them where they can go to support not only where you guys are doing in general, but also some of the places you're going to be hitting on your road tour.
Yes, absolutely. Our website is pinupsforpitbulls.org. We're on Instagram at pinupsforpitbullsinc and Facebook pinupsforpitbulls. And we have a lot going on in California, especially in NorCal and San Diego areas. We'll be at, let's see what's happening here, the City of Bedford Pet Fair in Dallas, Texas, the Morris Animal Foundation Walk for Canine Cancer in the San Jose area. And pretty much it's pretty endless. So if they go to pinupsforpitbulls.org/events, we're always looking for volunteers as well. So if people want to email us through our website, we're always looking for volunteers everywhere around the country.
Sounds all good right to me. Look at that. How tight. How tight.
More when we have more time.
How right. tight that pitch was.
That's right. There you go. She did it before.
She's on her thing.
Well, travel well, my dear. And
thank you, guys.
And feel free anytime you're out there on the road across America. Know that, you know, you can always call in here and let everybody know what's going on. Okay.
Absolutely. Maybe we can Skype from one of our events one day.
That would be awesome.
It works for us, man. You just let us know, okay?
I like it. We'll yes. figure it out.
Maybe
thank
something something
so
directly from the set of the shoot. That
that's
would
right.
be awesome.
Yeah, exactly. Now, yeah. That, what days are you shooting?
We are shooting the 14th to the 21st.
Okay.
Of April.
So
yeah, that'd be cool. Maybe we can do
it's
that.
It's a Tuesday and a Friday in between there, right?
Yes.
Hey, yeah. Skype right in from the set. That's a perfect, like, man, you know, Friday
like
would
it.
Friday is perfect, you know, and we can definitely, well, Tuesday or Friday or both, you know, whatever you want to do. But let's sell some calendars, man.
I love it. Let's
all right.
do it.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
Okay.
Thanks.
Have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye, dear.
Love and, that calendar, man. That's
know,
awesome.
This is an awesome, awesome calendar. So if you guys can pick your calendar up. Don't forget, because, you know, as a matter of fact, they're so awesome. I used mine 2 years in a row. Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, calendars are like one of those things where it's like
to the dates anyway. Like, it was the pictures.
Those things that, you know, usually if they're not in a digital format these days, like it's kind of like
that's
like
right.
taboo to have. But this is that's one of those right. things where the actual physical product is awesome. So
that's right.
Actually having the physical thing, it's like, you know, a classic
right.
book or
hey,
something like
we're
that.
We're gonna take a commercial and pay some bills before we do some dogs. But Regina, I'm seeing on the technical board here, the old computerized, and I'm not too savvy, that your Skype is kind of hard for Chris to maintain along with the dogs or something. So is it possible that you can phone in? And we can
sure.
capture a picture, put the dogs up. So,
is she doing the dogs?
Are you doing the dogs, or is
no,
Paula doing it? Oh, okay. Then it's okay. Well, we're gonna take a break.
I'll just have Regina call in, and we'll Skype with Paula.
Is that what you're saying?
Okay.
Yep. So we're gonna take a break, and he'll figure this out and tell me exactly what I'm talking about. Okay.
You're watching okay. Conversations with a Pit Bull Live, a show about dogs, the people that love them, and real issues. Brought to you by Pit Bull Energy Drink. Available in a wide variety of flavors, guaranteed no aftertaste. CWAPB Live will be right back after this dog fact of the day.
Dogs are about as smart as a 2 or 3 year old child. This means they can understand about 150 to 200 words, including signals and hand movements with the same meaning as words. Please support your local rescue groups. They do more to support your community than any others.
Hey, we're back. All right, so we're going to give a ringy-dingy to Paula Archer, and we're going to do our segment on rescuing some dogs. You know, that's what we do here every week is we try to get some dogs some homes. And look at that. Paula had a baby. Damn, that was a long commercial. Whoa.
Wow. What happened?
That's it. We leave you alone for 60 seconds, and there you go. You little rabbit.
Who is that? Who you got with you?
This is my grandson, Aiden.
Wow.
Aiden. Hey, man, you keep stacking those grandsons up, don't you?
You see?
Yeah. Wait a minute. You got another grandson, right?
Mason, he just had a birthday.
That's right, Mason. That's who he is.
It's a wonderful name.
Yeah.
sign that kid up.
Absolutely.
Now, Aiden's a big boy. You got your hands full.
Yeah, he'll be 2 next week.
2? Oh my yeah. goodness.
Moly.
Man, get the sports agents that's in right. there. Like, sign that kid up. He's a big boy.
And somebody else.
Good
yeah,
looking,
he's,
too.
He's going to be a bruiser.
Okay. Okay. So, hey, so we going to do some dogs today?
Yes, we are.
All right. Well, let's knock one or two of them off real quick. And Danny and I will sit back here and watch them and hope and pray that, you know, we can get somebody adopted and get a home here.
Good deal.
Okay.
All right, Chris, if you're ready. The first one we have up today, meet Rex. He is a good boy, just chilling here in the photo. He was dumped at the shelter by his former owner. Now Rex is in danger of being euthanized. Rex is hanging out in Thompsonton, Georgia, waiting for you to come home. Now we have Hurley. This little guy, just a pup, needs to be able to live a long and loving life, so that means he needs a forever home. He is located in Thomaston, Georgia, and you don't have to live in Georgia to save him. Transport can be arranged. Now we have this adorable pup is Jordash. She urgently needs an adopter, foster, or rescue. From this photo, you can tell all she wants to do is play. But unless she finds a way out of the shelter, she won't get that chance. Now, our sweet girl, Ruby. Ruby is waiting and waiting for her adopter or a rescue. Ruby looks to be a little older and past her puppy years. The more mature lady, she can be swept off her feet in Thompsonton, Georgia. If you don't live in Georgia, there are ways to get this honey to you. And now we have Tom Collins. Tom Collins is here waiting for his chance to shine. He wants to be adopted or rescued. See how patient he looks? If you cannot foster, consider sponsoring. If you cannot sponsor, consider sharing his photo. His life depends on it. James is our next one. James wants to live out his days in a loving home with lots of attention. He is currently residing in Upson County Animal Shelter, Thomason, Georgia. Here is the easy part. You don't have to live in Georgia to save his life. There are free transports out there. And now our next one. Oh no, he is another owner dub. JR wants to escape the death sentence his owners gave him by dumping him in this shelter. If you cannot adopt him, consider fostering. If you can't foster, consider sponsoring. If you can't sponsor, please at least share his picture with some friends. His life depends on it. These dogs are urgent and might not last through the day. They are located in the Upson County Animal Shelter in Georgia. And again, you do not have to live in Georgia to save these dogs. Transports are an option. There are some great free ones out there. Please call if you are interested or you have questions about any of these babies. Again, you must act fast. These dogs are all urgent. You can call Adrian Relaford, 706-647-5586 or Hope Masters at 904-797-9402. And if you would like to see these dogs, they are on Paws Pit Parade. You can see them there and get more information. Please stop by and see them and share. And those are all the dogs we have for today, guys.
Well, all right. Hey, man, listen.
Look at Aiden is knocked out, man. Aiden, he got rocking back and forth.
That's
he's
right.
Like,
Aiden is gone.
He's like, man, these dogs, they're in good hands. Let me just punch out real quick and
that's
get
right.
my little nap time.
Yeah. Aiden's laying there like, hey. I've been adopted. I got a home.
I'm good.
Yeah, Grandma, you work on getting those dogs some home. So hey, anybody in anywhere in the country actually. But what city was that?
Thomaston, Georgia.
Thomaston, Georgia.
Thomaston, I think it was Thomaston, Georgia. Thomaston.
Thomaston.
T-H-O-M-A-S-T-O-N. Thomaston.
Yeah, there's a couple of great looking animals there, man. And particularly, you know, I know somebody out there is like in the process of mixing up a mixed drink. So that little fella named Tom Collins could go right along with, you know, he fits right in with the plans for the evening.
Yeah,
you know?
So, yeah. If you guys have a chance and you're in that area, like Paula said, there's some transport opportunities and things to help make it easy. So if you're in that area or know somebody who is, or just have the ability to share the pictures, please do so. And if you missed any of that information, definitely hit Paula or Regina up on Paw's Pit Parade, and they can give you all the information on those dogs. I think we still got Regina and Cheryl both on the line. How you ladies doing?
Good, thank you.
Hey, I wanted to ask you guys about, did you guys hear about this story of this dog out in Washington that dug itself out of its own like grave?
No.
I haven't heard anything.
All right, so there's this, I think Chris has the pictures. There's this dog named Thea, right? And it's like a homeless dog that everybody in the town pretty much knows in this town up in Washington. And it got struck by by a driver or a hit and run or something, and the driver got out and I guess attempted like a mercy killing and like tried to kill this dog with a hammer basically, and buried it in a shallow grave. So 4 days later, like people in the town saw this dog basically limping around again in the around the town or whatever, and they realized that the dog had been buried. Yeah, it had been hit by a car, buried, and dug itself out of the grave. And finally somebody, from the rescue community
took it in,
and they're doing what you guys do.
See?
You know what I'm saying?
See?
Like they've got the surgery lined up to get it back on deck. It's got some breathing issues as a result of the hammer strike and stuff like that. But, it's just... I don't know. There's the capacity for these dogs is just it never ceases to amaze me, and just to see how much they want to live and want to be a part of people's lives. It was just amazing, this story.
That's right. But you see that, Paula? I told you. See, that's the way that I'm gonna go. Okay. All right. So, okay. Now, a couple of days after they say you hear Foster's dead, look for me. All right.
Okay.
Because I'm gonna be trying to dig my way back out. You know, I'm not going easy. All right. So, okay.
This is. I mean, it brings up a lot of different. I mean, it's just a wonderful story. I mean, it's a miracle dog, and you hear like wonderful. Even these tough kind of stories, you hear so much wonderful things that dogs are capable of, but it kind of brought up an issue that I wanted to talk to you guys about was like, they always say if you accidentally like hit something or hit a person or whatever, you see so many, especially out here in LA, people drive off all the time. I think we lead the nation in hit and run accidents or whatever, because I don't know
we cowards. Fast cars.
Yeah, as soon as you run, as soon as you leave, it's a criminal act. This person didn't leave, but tried. I don't know. I don't think they found this person yet, but they're saying trying to do a mercy killing.
Yeah, I'm beating them with a hammer.
It just doesn't even make any sense to
me.
But
it does kind of bring up. What city was this in?
It was in Washington
Pullman,
State.
Washington.
Yeah.
Why? Like Washington up Cheryl's way.
Yeah, Washington State. It was a day ago. At
Moses Lake.
Must have been a tree driver.
It was only a year old, and they're saying it's a pit bull mix. It was had multiple fractures and was severely malnourished, you think?
Yeah, see? Yeah, somebody had him back there in the woods. He looks good now, though.
Yeah?
Yeah, he
much
looks
better.
Yeah,
he
looks
raised,
real good.
They've raised over $10,000 for his surgery and care. So
Okay, so you guys remember that. Now, when y'all hear about Foster's back...
I think the lady who rescued the dog's name was Sarah Mulatto. So props to you, sweetheart.
That's right, Sarah.
For taking this dog in. But it raised some questions to me, Cheryl and Regina, about this the humanity or the you know, these issues of what's humane. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. obviously taking a hammer to a dog is whatever. But in the larger sense of putting dogs down, you know, like in conditions like that where they are kind of like, you know, but obviously right. this dog had a lot of heart and a lot of life still in them, you know. It's like you can't
well,
just...
you hear once in a while of a dog that they euthanized at a shelter and dumped it in a bag or something, and turned out the dog survived the euthanasia and is just trying to get back, you know, get out of the bag. The will to live is incredibly strong.
That's right.
This is one of those cases where you're happy that your dog is digging. You know what I mean? Like, I know in the backyard you're like, oh, I keep my dog from digging or whatever, but this is incredible. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. He needs
he
to teach some classes.
I'm gonna put you in that hole.
Yep. What about you, Regina? What do you think?
Well, it's interesting because yesterday I saw another story like that. I don't know if you all saw it, but it was in China where a man hit a dog. The dog got stuck in his bumper. He hit the dog and just decided, oh, well, I guess he's dead, and he kept on driving. And the poor dog got stuck in the bumper, and he drove 248 miles.
Wow.
Yes, wow. And he finally heard the dog barking, got out, and then drove back to his hometown, left the dog in the bumper even longer to go back to the vet. But when he got back to the vet, apparently he adopted the dog after because he felt like it was fate. But he still... Initially, you know, my question is, you never stop to check the dog when you hit it, you know?
Yeah, that's kind of...
Yeah.
You know, so he's
well,
a good Samaritan.
You know, different people have different ideas about dogs and cats in relation to our relationship with them. And there's a lot of people out there still that are pretty old school, that it's like if a dog gets hit by a car, you just put it out of its misery. You don't bother going to the vet or whatever. You know, so, you know, and China has a different culture, so good
he
for
ended
him
up adopting
for the dog, you know?
Man, well, I tell you. So, Cheryl, what's happening up there in...
Hotland?
Yeah.
Oh, not a whole lot. Just getting ready to have a bully walk sometime this month. We're going to have our pit bull education booth at the Northwest Pet and Companion Fair on the 18th, which we always look forward to. And this year we get to give a presentation on responsible dog ownership in relation to breed-specific legislation, because I think we all agree that the more responsible dog owners we have that have complete control of their dogs, regardless of what kind of dog it is, the less need municipalities are going to feel to make laws that ban certain kinds of dogs. So that's always good news to get out. And that's pretty much it. It's just regular Oregon stuff up here. Don't have anything special going on. But on to what Danny was talking about, I don't know. It's hard to say when an animal is suffering too much, and even though it has a will to live, maybe it would be better to put it out of its misery when there's extreme, you know, issues. All I know is with my dogs, when they were sick, when they had cancer, the time I knew to put them down was when I even suspected that they were suffering, even a little bit, and I couldn't handle the thought of that. So if I can't take the suffering away, then I need to let them go. So that's been a really tough one. You see a lot of dogs with a lot of injuries. There's some pretty extreme. There's London, the dog that has no front legs, that is just as active as any other pit bull on the planet. So it's I guess it's a case-by-case thing.
So, Regina, you got anything going on we need to know about?
Well, I was going to just mention a little information about, have you guys heard of the dogs being used in the courtrooms?
Nah.
What the ones that when they pat you down and sniff you for drugs?
No, this is there's an organization called Courthouse Dogs. You can go to courthousedogs.com.
Uh-huh.
But they're using dogs in the courtroom, And the victims are benefiting, as well as the judges, lawyers, and victim advocates, because the dog's calming presence creates a more humane and efficient system. And, you know, it's helping, like, some children, very young children that have been, like, had to testify for child abuse or things like that. They actually will have the dog right in the behind in the court seat. And sometimes they're out of view, and it helps the child be calm and have a calm presence and be able to function a little easier.
Oh, they so, use it for kids, not for adults.
It's for everyone. Yes.
Really?
It's,
the guy that's on trial for double murder, they sent a pit bull up there to chill him out so he can.
No, this is for the victims. These are therapy dogs that ease stress for the victims of violent crimes.
Okay. I was just trying to make it clear because I wasn't sure there. I was like, wait a minute. You know, so wait. I'm wondering because I got this this speeding ticket, right? So you think
another one?
The same one. So, yeah, right. So you think,
what's interesting is he wasn't even in a car. He was just walking real fast.
Yeah. So you think maybe I can go to court and I take Grip with me.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they say, well, what do you got to say for yourself? And I was like, well, Your Honor, well, actually,
the dog was driving,
you know, and yeah. And, you know, so. And I'm just here to calm him down because, you know, this is the third ticket that he's gotten. And he's
rolling the dice walking around, brother, with a pit bull to a courtroom voluntarily. I would advise against that. You know how these cops are shooting these
dogs. Just go ahead and pay that $300.
Did you guys hear about that story too? I mean, I'm always looking around on the internet for stories and stuff. But like, you know, we've been talking a lot about how these cops are just shooting people's animals, shooting dogs
and people
shooting whatever. But that's I think right. The other day in New York City. There was an altercation. It didn't have anything to do with this dog or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. Like these two people were fighting or whatever in out in Brooklyn somewhere, and officer showed up or whatever, and a pit bull was, you know, like off to the side
across
or whatever,
the street.
And so the officer pulls out his gun and shoots at the pit bull, the charging pit bull or whatever, right?
Right.
So the bullet. It's like some JFK or whatever. It's like the bullet grazes the dog, bounces off a wall, and then hits the officer in the foot, and he has to go to the hospital.
Oh, that's funny.
So I was like, yeah. Payback, dude. So he shot himself in the foot or whatever. Like, or it may have been his superior officer or somebody, right. But like his partner or
right,
something.
Right.
But, you know, he was.
Oh, that's
it had
funny.
Nothing to do with like the altercation
There's
or what
altercation
was going on. It was
just
like.
He just saw a pit bull.
Just a
and
chance.
An
and he's shooting hollow points
shoot.
Too. I'm like, who's issuing these cops these hollow point? I mean, it's
right.
Just a whole nother level. But
wow,
you were telling me too, Star.
Danny, there's. I thought you were going to tell the story where I think it was last week, 2 weeks ago, a cop responded to a domestic disturbance, and it was a man and his wife fighting over custody of their child or whatever, and things got pretty heated, and the cop got there, and their dog, which is I think a pit bull, jumped in and was trying to. You know, help somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And the police officer shot at the dog, missed the dog, shot the woman, and killed her in front of her 4-year-old child.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Yeah.
It's like an everyday
wow.
thing. Everyday thing, it seems like. People just need to chill out, you know?
It's a pit bull shoot.
Speaking of chilling out, Foster, you were telling me about some interesting news in Colorado. Right.
Oh man, yeah. I'm trying to find a story. Did you guys hear about that? There's a lawmaker, like not senator, but one of these, that's passing a law for the state for doggy marijuana prescription.
Doggy marijuana.
Yeah, for prescription for you get your dog weed.
You know, I have not heard of that.
I know. And I just was saying, like, holy shit, grip, your glaucoma is going to be cured.
Well, before they make any laws about getting dogs marijuana in Colorado, they need to make a law that will not allow the cities of Aurora or Denver to have a breed ban anymore. That's the kind of law they should be making.
Yeah.
Well, no, they're trying everything they can, apparently.
Well, maybe if they say that, you know, your pit bull is a little medicated, he won't be so, we won't have to pass the law for breed specific legislation or something. Maybe it's a step law or something, you know, that they saying, well, he was just chilling, you know. Your Honor, this dog.
You make your pit bull stoned and he's just too out there to even think about growling or biting anybody.
This dog has a marijuana prescription card, so we don't think that he has to be put on the breed specific legislation list. And I think what they're saying is this is some sort of a reduced. I got to find the story. You know I came across it, but this is some sort of a reduced marijuana. Although, you know, there is someone makes something called, what is it? It's puppy pot? Something like that.
Don't look over here, man. Why are you looking over here? I'm the authority on this issue. Like,
Daddy,
I have one forgivable
medication to give.
Hey, I have one forgivable vice, and it usually has a cork in it. So.
Let me see. Okay, dog weed brownies. I'm gonna pull it up here. I know that somebody makes something because it's like puppy pot or something like that. But it's a reduced concentration marijuana thing for prescription for dogs who may just have stress, you know, and anxiety, you know. But I would imagine, if you're a dog living in Colorado, if you're a pit bull living in Colorado, Cheryl, you're going to have plenty of anxiety, huh?
Damn straight. You're going to be, like, looking over your shoulder all the time. You know, you hear a sound outside. You're like, I'm going to go hide in the bathroom.
Yeah. So here, I'll have it. I'll look it up next time. But I know, I'm pretty sure it's in Colorado where they're passing it. But Colorado is going ape shit for marijuana and everything right now. You know, it's like, I think their business has jumped from $100 a year to like $150 million on marijuana now. You know,
it's legal in Washington State, and they got stores now. And then in July, we're going to start it here in Oregon.
For guys like me that are in the drinking, there's this stuff called Bowser beer, and it's a beer that you can share with your dogs. It's non-alcoholic, and it comes in meat and chicken flavors and stuff like that. So I'm gonna look into these guys and see if my dogs Jack and Jill want to step their non-alcoholic adult beverage game up.
Yeah, see there. So. Yep. So wait a minute. Let me find out. Do we have any more dogs out there, Paula Archer?
No, no more dogs today.
Okay. Then, what?
Chris has these pictures that we wanted to share of me and Foster in my new backyard building this dog kennel.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So we were me and my wife, we just were renting a new house, and I had to find a way to corral these dogs when I'm not around, and they've got these cool kind of like do-it-yourself things at Home Depot where you can just they're modular building type things, and they've got canopies on them and for shade and weather protection and stuff, and my uncle's gonna come by early next week and we're gonna build dog houses and stuff within the enclosure. But Chris is just playing a couple of the pictures of us in the backyard setting up these kennels. I think it came out pretty good. Jack and Jill, my dogs, they're American Bulldogs. They really seem to like it.
Yeah, you got to take some pictures of the dogs in there.
Yeah. I'll find a couple of Jack and Jill. I probably got some in my phone somewhere. But
hey, look at that.
Hey, look at Chris. See how he composited himself in there.
And see, but Chris just he showed up at the end with beer.
Yeah, but he that had was, a. It was interesting because we both were wearing our t-shirts and cargo shorts, and Chris just somehow appeared with a hammer and a suit and tie on. That was really cool.
Yeah, right. Yeah, he's wearing a tie in the backyard.
He was happy to assume the supervision role. He didn't need to get dirty down and dirty with us.
On that 80-degree day.
But it was cool. We had a great time. It's always cool to hang out and do something productive, and the dogs really appreciate it. I just have to go to the next step and get a little doghouse type thing
on
built.
On that concrete slab.
But my uncle's going to help me out with that. And,
cool.
We had a good time. It was,
that's right.
Because I was like, I don't know what that. I'm not that very handy with hammers and nails and stuff. But luckily, they had these little modular things that you can get at Home Depot, and they weren't too terribly expensive. So
yeah, that's right. But and it wasn't IKEA either.
Yeah.
Okay. That was like put it together, drive stakes in the ground, do the whole 9 yards. But that sucker's standing up there, you know. So that's the amazing part. I said. Until the dogs get in there, though. That's why I want to see the pictures of the dogs in there, because you know how it is, Cheryl. You know, until it's doggy tested, it ain't real.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, you better believe it, you especially know? If it's a big dog.
Yeah, they got to put that weight on them, because, you know, when it comes time to get out of there, Paula, you got 6 of them, so you know, you imagine, when they go on the... and not attack, but they get on that mission to we getting out of here. It better be sturdy, right?
Oh yeah, it's like they send the scout out. The scout goes out and looks for the weak spot.
Yeah,
then learns like, hey, over here.
Right.
Here.
Yeah,
you know,
and it's like mission. Yeah, like Mission Impossible. They've got one for every task. You know, they say, "Hey, we need a heavy. We need to put some weight on it over here." You know, then the big guy steps up, and then you got your digger. You know, then you got your smeller. You know, it's like, and then the howler. You know, the one that sits out there and lets everybody know, "Oh, come over here." So hey, we're gonna.
Chris,
you have the one, then you have the one picks. That gets your attention while the other ones are over there doing what they're not supposed to.
Yeah, exactly. That's the, what do they call, bait and switchers. So, hey, we're going to take a break, and we're going to pay our last bill with the Pitbull Energy Drink, you know, hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com.
Hey.
And that's right. Eat energy. And so anybody out there, just go to your computer. Keep us on the air because, you know, it's these cans, man.
I'm going to start looking into that Bowser beer. Maybe they got an interest in what we're doing.
That might be a sponsor, man. Hey, everybody across country, drink your beer and drink with your dog and watch the show and talk to us. So we'll be right back after this.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pitbull energy drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.
All right, we're back. Hey, we're back. Foster had to run handle some business of his own. I think, did you get those pictures yet, Chris?
Yeah, I'm transferring them over.
Oh, okay, cool. Paula, I see you're fully representing Alabama. You got the Alabama shirt on, representing. How's the new home treating you, and how's the new community down there?
Well, every state that I've lived in, their colors have been red for mm-hmm. their teams.
Yeah.
You know, of course, Ohio State and Nebraska and Oklahoma, they all have red. And so when we moved here and I saw their shirts, it was like, okay, I can get behind them. They're red.
Well, don't come to L.A. with that stuff.
Right.
Yeah, well, you know. But anyway, the people here are very nice, very friendly, laid back. They're not stressed out like northern people are. And I can say that because I'm from the north. But,
City folk.
City folks. Man, it's probably got something to do with all that doggy marijuana floating around there.
Yeah, they probably grow it around here. I don't know. Yeah. I have, you know, actually seen it. But.
Between that and Billy Bob Steele. Back there in the woods. Don't go down that road there, Sheriff. Ain't nothing down there but a bridge. Yeah,
I can't wait. I'm going out to I think Nashville, I think in May.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, early May. My cousin's graduating law school, so I'm gonna be in those neck of the woods. Well, I always have a blast out there, man.
Yeah, just
love the country. Love the country.
Yeah, well, I'm not necessarily a country feller. Although I was up there around Cheryl's parts, and man, a couple of hundred miles from Manzanilla, but I drove down one of those Portland roads, one of those Oregon roads, Cheryl, where you drive for an hour and you don't pass nothing but trees.
Yeah.
Going for like 70 miles an hour.
That's like every road.
Yeah, I ended up at a lumberjack convention or something like that, you know? I was the only brother there. Can you believe it?
I can believe that. Yeah, that's the one part.
Come to Portland. You'll have plenty of company.
It was like everybody there. We drove for 70 miles, like, you know, for an hour, going 70 miles an hour past nothing but trees. And then there was this turnout. Turned in there, and everybody in the town that came to this, you know, it was a contest, you know, convention, event kind of thing. Everybody had on overalls. Except,
oh, my goodness.
Except for the mayor. And
he wasn't wearing anything at all, right?
Right, you know.
And he was just putting his little sprinkle on.
You know, and like, you know, 8 or 10 other people. But it was like overall city, you know. And man, it was so funny because me and Nathaniel were, you know, in the truck, and we were the only brothers in there. But they were nice people. That was the other thing. That was the main thing.
Oh, yeah.
It was like, they were so cool, you know?
Yeah, when we moved from California to Oregon, the first thing that we noticed, was how friendly the people were.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's a nice place to be. If you don't mind rain.
Yeah,
it's a wonderful place to be. Lots of mountains.
Yeah, you have to like rain, that's for sure. Because we pulled into town, and the first thing they were saying was, "Nice rig," you know, in my truck, and it was brand new, and also like a lot of people sit out in the morning time. You know, it's like Mayberry and stuff. You know Manzanilla?
I do know Manzanita. I go there frequently. We take our dogs on the beach there.
Man.
It's a beautiful little town, and there's some great pizza to be found there, too.
I love that place. I'll be honest with you. I mean, if you're talking about a laid-back, a retirement, or you know, to have you a place to kick back, oh, my God, Manzanita. It's large beaches. They're like one of the biggest beaches where you can windsurf and stuff.
That's beautiful like, territory. My mother took my grandmother and her sister out to Oregon last year. Just taking, you know, my grandma's like 91 or whatever, and just driving through Oregon to see the waterfalls and all cliffs, that stuff. And it was just, I mean, some of the pictures they were sending back were just beautiful. Last time I was up there was years ago to do some salmon fishing, but it's such a beautiful thing. I think Chris found some pictures of my dog, just so you guys can see. That's Jill.
Uh-oh.
Jill's got her tongue hanging out.
Look at Jill. That's her biggie.
And her brother Jack.
Oh, yeah.
Jack's got one blue eye, one-eyed Jack.
They Jack real bulldogs.
Jack and Jill, American bulldogs, and I think he's got a picture of me and my brother. We were taking him to the vet, and Jill got a chance to ride in my brother's car, trying to peek out the sunroof and stuff like
man,
that.
Man,
so.
that kennel's got to be the real deal, man.
Yeah, no, they're big. I think Jack is maybe around 90 pounds, and yeah. Jill's a little chubby. She's about 80 something. So I need to get them walking and stuff like that, but they're enjoying stuff, and
yeah, boy,
you know, just so you guys see the dogs in my life.
Yeah,
so.
Those some biggies, man. So I'm sure that kennel's got to be the real deal, show, because these bad boys they look like when they lean against it, if it's not sturdy, it's going down.
They're real, you know? They're real tame though. They're not they're not crazy at all. Good. But they're, you know, I mean, they're bulldogs,
they're
so
bulldogs,
it's like
though. Yeah,
you know,
Danny, when I get out there. You know, I've got to hug them.
Oh, yeah. No, I was saying if you can do what you did to Aiden to these dogs, I'd be forever in your debt. Cause,
hey, I rock them.
Knock them down.
Like a three or four rock. We could get a package deal. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't mind. I got $20 for that because Aiden was high. He was, like, waving in the camera. And then, right, like, right. 3 seconds later, by dog number two, he was lights out. So,
so hey, guys, I'm getting the signal that now it's time to say goodbye to all our family. So, we're going to get out. Thank you, Pitbull Energy Drink. And subscribe. Hit the button. Keep us on the air. And we got some good stuff coming up here.
Anybody knows anything about Bowser Beer, give them a buzz. See if
that's
they...
right. Bowser Beer, I'll look them up and give them a jingle, you know, and see. Hey.
Don't forget FX, Pickup Breeder X.
Thank you. I forgot about all that. So you guys, if you're watching this, you know the things we got happening. Go to our Facebook pages, Breeder X, Conversations with a Pitbull. You know, like that. Pause Pit Parade. Foster's Adoptables, Foster's Animal World on YouTube, because you're watching that now. If you're watching this, well, not if you're watching the archive version. So subscribe, support us, period, across the board, whatever the hell we're doing, because we're doing it for you guys. You know, so Cheryl, Paula, Nina, Fred, Deirdre, everybody out there.
Chris. Thanks for helping us build that shelter in your suit, man.
That's
I know
right.
you don't like
That's
to get
right.
your stuff dirty.
And bringing that doggy beer by afterwards, you know. So we'll see you guys next week. Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye, all.
And I
Bye.
Leave this message.